Hi, my name's Jennifer Stokes. I'm a senior lecturer in digital literacy and information literacy in Education Futures at UniSA.
How did you approach your course design using UDL?
When I was approaching my course design using UDL, I was really lucky to have a really strong academic developer at the university present this as an idea to me, and I could see the benefits of it. Teaching within enabling programs, you're working with a lot of students from diverse backgrounds and students from equity groups. So using UDL is a real chance to level the playing field, to kind of preemptively address a lot of the barriers that students might face to learning. So, thinking about that, I tried to think about the position of a student as they're accessing content, so thinking about things like my course design, thinking about having a range of different options with assessments and different ways that students could show their learning throughout the course was really important.
What key considerations did you make?
In utilising UDL, some of the key considerations I made were thinking about the different needs of students. And one of the great things about using UDL principles for course design is that you're preemptively addressing a lot of issues, and things you might put in place, say for a student with hearing impairment, might also be useful for students with low data rates who need text-based content, that sort of thing. So thinking more broadly about some of those issues, setting up my course so that it addressed them, and so that then students had less barriers to learning.
Outline some of the things you altered in your course to ensure it had more of a UDL focus.
I think one of the really big things that I altered was assessments. So for example, in the digital literacy course that I coordinate, I really kind of exploded open the options around assessments, with the idea there that students had that real aspect of choice, they could play to their strengths, and it was quite empowering. This was quite challenging as well, because I then had to think about how could I articulate really clearly for the students through rubrics what I was assessing them on, and how something like an app could be graded in the same way as a critical digital media review. So that forced me as an educator to really clearly state these are the kinds of things that I'm looking for across a range of formats. I then also made sure that for students they could see how they were being graded, that was very clear, that they could see examples, so that helped them model what they were creating. They're all creating unique products, but it gave them a real sense of the kind of standard and expectations that they were pitching towards. So making those things really clear was, I think really helpful.
What advice would you give others who are thinking about redesigning their course using a UDL approach?
The advice I give to others who are thinking about redesigning their course using a UDL approach is just to go for it. It's time that's well spent. So it might seem a bit challenging at first, but investing that time now will really help you later on, and it's better for the students. So rather than them hitting blocks and needing to reach out to you as an educator, it makes the learning more seamless for them when they're in the course. So yes, it does take a bit of time and energy to set up, but it's so beneficial. I'd really encourage you to go ahead with it.
What difference has it made for you as an educator?
I guess the difference that UDL has made for me as an educator is that it's really helped me think through issues of access and inclusion. Inclusive education has always been something that's really close to my heart, and especially through technology-enhanced learning, and applying UDL principles really assisted with that. So there's a real ethical imperative for it, but it's also really interesting. So giving those different options for students, those multiple means of things like expression and engagement, as Cass talk about, really helps support all these really diverse outcomes that play to students' strengths, but also means that you're not stuck kind of looking at the same assessment all the time. So it's a really rewarding approach, and I'd really just encourage people to consider adopting it.
What impact has it had on your learners?
I think one of the big impacts that UDL has had on my learners is they need to ask less questions because there's less barriers in the way to learning. So they're able to get into the course site. If they're looking at the assessments, then they can say, oh, here are some examples of what's expected of me. It's really clear how I'm going to be assessed. All of those sorts of things, rather than reaching out to us, then hitting those stumbling blocks, they can go ahead and progress with their learning. So it's been really beneficial for them. It's also really empowering, because for students coming from all sorts of diverse backgrounds, it's placing less barriers in their way. So it's really thinking about how can I make this course universally accessible, and then that supports all sorts of different learners. So I've had really positive feedback from students, and I also think the quality of their work has improved because they're not hitting those little kind of speed bumps along the way. Instead, they're able to focus clearly on their learning.
This video was produced for the Universal Design for Learning and Tertiary Education e-learning resource. For more information, visit www.disabilityawareness.com.au.